Hello and welcome to Dentistry 101. Today we'll talk about something all dentists use before working, which is the local anaesthesia. If you like the video, please hit like and subscribe. Local anaesthesia forms the major part of the pain control techniques in dentistry. The prevention and elimination of pain during dental treatment has benefited the patients and the doctors, enabling the dental professionals to make tremendous therapeutic advances that would have never been done without them. Historically, inhuman techniques were used to perform procedures. Some civilizations invented techniques to overcome this pain, like the Egyptians, which used carotid compression technique, which involves cutting of the blood supply from the person till he passes out and then performing the procedure. However, the improvement in the anaesthesia techniques made the procedure much easier. The most common used dental local anaesthesia are benzocaine, lidocaine, bupivacaine, diazepam, and tetracycline. They are different from the general anaesthetics, which induce unconsciousness for the patient. Originally, the first local anaesthetic used was cocaine, but because of its addictive effect, it is no longer used. The most common local anaesthetics used are lidocaine and benzocaine. The lidocaine injection, which is used by the dentists, has rapid onset and it produces local anesthesia. It is recommended to use benzocaine surface anesthesia before the lidocaine injection to make the patient not feel the injection pinch, which some of the patients feel afraid from. Pain transmission to the brain happens through sodium ions along the nerves. The movement of the sodium ions into the nerve cells transmits the pain impulse to the brain. Local anesthesia prevents the sodium entrance to the nerve by blocking the sodium channels. This will eliminate the transmission of the pain to the brain. Hence, there will be no nerve depolarization and no feeling of the pain. Adrenaline or epinephrine is added to the anesthetic solution, which acts as a vasoconstrictor. Its action is to constrict the blood vessels, which will decrease the circulation of the anesthesia throughout the body, decreasing the systemic effect of the local anesthesia and keeping the anesthesia away from vital organs such as the heart. This reduction in blood flow also decreases the washing away of the anesthesia in the local site, which increases the action time of the anesthesia in the site. Also confines the anesthesia to the specific site and increases its concentration in it, increasing the effect. However, the presence of this adrenaline or norepinephrine is contraindicated in some patients who have heart diseases or uncontrolled hypertension or uncontrolled hyperthyroidism or uncontrolled diabetes. The adrenaline will cause more harm than benefit, so using an adrenaline-free local anesthesia is indicated in these cases. Try to use the red anesthesia, which does not have adrenaline or has a small amount of adrenaline, in patients having these diseases, and use the normal green anesthesia containing adrenaline or epinephrine in all of the other patients. The local anesthetic injection for treating the upper teeth is mostly the infiltration injection, and the lower teeth is mostly the nerve block. Because of the mandibular bone being much stronger and dense than the maxillary bone, infiltration anesthesia for the lower teeth will have a weak effect. Upper nerve block techniques could be used, however, they are very dangerous and must be used with care. They are used if there is a condition which could make the infiltration anesthesia contraindicated, such as having a maxillary dental abscess, in which the local infiltration could cause a spread. Buccal infiltration for the upper teeth is enough, however, palatal infiltration is recommended during extractions. Lower buccal infiltration is used with the nerve block when lower tooth extraction is to be made. Other anesthetic techniques such as intrapulpal or intraligamentary techniques are very useful during restorative procedures, especially endodontics. They eliminate a big portion of pain from acute inflamed pulp. They must be used after using infiltration or nerve block techniques, depending on the tooth being upper or lower. Patients undergoing the dental treatment for the first time should be tested for the anesthesia hypersensitivity by injecting a small portion of the anesthetic into the skin to make sure that they don't have any sensitivity or anaphylactic shock, which is life-threatening. Some people think that anesthesia is contraindicated for the pregnant woman because it decreases the blood supply for the fetus, which could cause problems. However, researchers found that the endogenous adrenaline released by the body during pain is much more than the amount present in the anesthetic injection, so it is safer to treat the pain of the pregnant woman instead of fearing of giving her dental injection. To be on the safe side, use the red anesthetic injection, which has little or no adrenaline. To summarize, Local anesthetic solutions are safe to use in most of the patients except the patients having heart diseases, uncontrolled hypertension, uncontrolled hyperthyroidism, and uncontrolled diabetes. These patients require the use of the red anesthesia containing low amount of adrenaline. And this brings an end to our video Local Anesthetics 101. If you like the video, please hit like and subscribe. Thank you for watching.